Yeah, we back up in this. Y'all already know. Cause I am the baddest of them all. If you ain't about money, then I don't mess with y'all. Y'all think I don't get girls, cause I ain't very tall. If she see my stacks, I bet you.
Try to be a good person, you know? Don't hold grudges. Let things go. The past is in the past. You move on, man. Not everything horrible in life needs to have ramifications that are carried with you for the rest of your life. But that shit does not apply in the slightest to the 1998 Roland Emmerich first attempt at an American Godzilla movie. Because that shit, I will never forgive it. No forgiveness. Ever. We will never, ever allow anybody to say, even if he was a 5-year-old kid, right? He's like, I saw it when I was a kid. So I like Godzilla 98. Well, how old are you now? Because you should know that that shit was like, honestly, only cool to you because you was 5 and had like giant like monsters and shit. But that wasn't even Godzilla. You was lied to. You was, wait a minute. My name is Old School. And welcome back. This Godzilla movie now. Now, obviously, y'all know I'm a huge ass Godzilla fan. Like, it's the one thing that like people want to talk about, talk about it. But I'm not into fandoms like to throw it in people's faces. You know what I mean? So I don't go around all day talking about fucking Godzilla and shit. Like, I think like Marvel and Star Wars are great. Like, I love that shit, man. But for me, it's Godzilla. That's like my personal shit from growing up and watching all the real movies. Right? There's a huge difference between watching the original Godzilla vs. Smog Monster, right? On Channel 11 when I was 5, and then going to see it now and being like, oh, it's so still great because it's cheesy and funny, and it's still got the big man crushing shit with his feet, right? Love it. Love, what's not to love about Godzilla, man? Everything not to love about Godzilla is in this Roland Emmerich fucking movie, man. It's like trying to, like, oh, God. I don't even know where to begin here. I don't even know where to begin here. You know how much I love Godzilla. And I waited for that movie. And I waited for it. I waited for it more, with more anticipation than, say, The Phantom Menace. You know what I mean? Which I still kind of feel the same way about The Phantom Menace. I did the first time. I was like, that's all right, I guess. You know what I mean? But the weird thing about this Godzilla movie is it was not all right. Like, I tried to get, like, completely obliterated, stoned, and drunk and watch it for laughs and be like, well, it's Zilla. You know, it's a thing. It's like, no, it's never funny. It's never enjoyable. It's never well acted. And Godzilla being taken out by missiles. Let's just put a fucking, I wish I had bullet points or had the time to put some shit in there. Bullet point number one. Godzilla does not get killed by human missiles. That is not anything even related to what the character is. He's so strong. The whole point is you can't kill him. They had to use an oxygen destroyer. That was the only way to do anything at all that killed Godzilla in the original movie, dude. So, missiles on the bridge. We got him trapped up on a bridge. I don't think I'm going to have any semblance of review here because now the anger is coming out. Now the rage is coming out, man. That a whole generation of people grew up thinking that that was Godzilla and he was just a goddamn giant iguana. Iguana. I mean, for fuck's sake, people. I mean, it's kind of crazy on the Japanese movies, dude. Fucking, Godzilla was a dinosaur in that weird little section of, I believe that was either the late 90s or early 2000s series, where it was a Godzillasaurus, and that was a little bit like, okay, but they were on, like, the 37th movie by the time they threw that shit in there, and like, in the Japanese Godzilla movies, man, like, dude, they rebooted that shit all the time. It was like, sometimes they, like, rebooted it 4 times, 4 movies in a row, you know what I mean? So they did a lot of crazy shit over there, whatever. But there's no fucking excuse with this America shit, because it was the first time we had it. It was the first time we had it. Get out of here, smoke. Seriously, like, how do you blow it so bad? I mean, well, first of all, they gave it to Roland Emmerich, right? Okay, let me get to some kind of place on track here, right? The motherfucker never directed a goddamn thing that was ever genuinely good. Right, Independence Day, so bad it's good, but not good. Day After Tomorrow, 2012, dude, they were like, give Godzilla to him because he directs disaster stuff, but doesn't even direct disaster stuff well. Like, Roland Emmerich, like, this guy, like, I hate M. Night Shyamalan, right, but I will literally punch Roland Emmerich in the face if I ever see him on the goddamn street. I hate that motherfucker so much. I mean, I really don't, but I kind of do, though. I really kind of do, because Godzilla in 98. Godzilla 98, man. I felt they just did me dirty. They didn't care. I feel like they literally bent me over and strapped me to a goddamn wall and raped my ass. I feel fucking, I will never let it go. Ever. Like, I'm not... Zero stars. Gotta calm myself down. I'm gonna give myself a heart attack. Like, I thought doing these would be fun, right? But there's a reason why I never tackled horrible movies when I was spending my time doing my house reviews and editing them and going through YouTube, getting clips and stills off Google and stuff like that, man, writing out a script. Dude, there's a reason why I picked movies that were underrated, unknown, overlooked, because I had something to talk about that was, okay, here's the bad aspects, but here's the good aspects. And here's how those two things work in conjunction to give you something fantastic, right? These bad movies, man, I can't create enough metaphors fast enough to get the venom out of my mouth that's like gurgling from the acids in my stomach of pure loathing, seething hatred. This is shaving years off my life, guys. So I hope you're fucking enjoying these. In some way, shape, or form, I have to go fucking get fucking high to get over this now. I'll see you all tomorrow or the next day.